Hello! So I've got two beers here from the same brewery. Horbury Brew Company. This is the White Oak Pale. And this is the Toffee Oatmeal Stout. It's currently January and everybody's doing the hashtag Tryanuary. Purchased these today by a beer house out of Austin. So this is the Toffee Oatmeal Stout. A robust stout created by the original brewers of Horbury Ales, giving a toasted toffee caramel aroma and flavour with a strong bitter finish, not too sweet. Traditional ingredients are raised at 5%. Nice little artwork on the can. So apparently the used to be Horbury Ales and now it's Horbury Brew Company. But yeah, it's like wheat and toffee and such. But yeah, it's Tryanuary. Generally, a lot of breweries and bottle shops are doing Tryanuary at the moment, where you try a new brewery. So here we go. You might get the toffee elements. Now I'm trying to rewind and try to remember oatmeal. We all know oatmeal is typically used for porridges and stuff like that. Or oat cookies. But anyway, cheers. There it is. It kind of tastes like an oat cookie. And if you dipped it in like I don't want to say, I'm trying to think of a, cause it is a bit oaty on the palate, but it's not aromatic on the palate with the oats. But you are tasting like it's this toffee flowing through it, but it's, it doesn't include it on the ingredients. So it's with sweetness. But Horbury is just outside of Ossett, and on the way to Wakefield. It does taste nice. This is the White Hawk. I don't think I've ever seen the hawks flying around Horbury before, but lots of seagulls and pigeons. Another kind of birds, but never a hawk. In Yorkshire, we tend to get kites and kestrels and such like that. It's a strange aroma. Anyway, cheers. I'm not the same thing because I'm a bit kind of detrimental to the beer, but I don't know. Cheers. Yeah. It's not great. kind of tastes like stale biscuits. Or a cream ale. A blend of four high alpha US hops. This pale ale is the first of our craft brews. Oxley hoppy, you can expect dank citrus. And grapefruit as well, as you kind of get a little bit of grapefruit. But when you get a growler and then let it sit on open for a while, it does taste like stale beer. As well as floral tropical. Aggressive color. Not to drink it, but there's some slight airs there, but it kind of has like a flower element to it, but not in a nice way. It kind of smells like cheese. I've had cheese. You get a little bit of sawdusty aroma. It has some dankness to it, but I don't know, tell. Yeah, it's alright. It's not as bad as the first time, but it just tastes a little bit on the thin side and not too pleasurable. That works nice though. Right, so that's the two Horbury beers. Next on to the next two beers. So, next two is one from Leeds and one from what is it? Harrogate. So, well, they'll be on. Daleside. Now, this is really a Tryanuary beer for me because I've had it many times over the past years. But I've had it for a good while. So, kind of. The second one, Zapato. This is the export porter, 7%, 2020 rather. Very industrial and at work. But yes, released just before my birthday. It was released on the 16th of the 11th, 2020. So, these are bottles, the butterfly. I am looking forward to the Daleside one because I've been thinking about it for the past few weeks, but the only place that I've seen still stock it is Beer House out of Osset. Yes, I just passed it. But yes, so what I'll do is I'll dive into the Daleside first, because it's lower end ABV. But yes, they have added it to 5.4%. I did see that the artwork's changed slightly. But yeah, it's just a strong ale with a 5.3% beers of distinction. But yes, I used to drink this all the time when I first get into real ale. Be the glass, dark, honey brown looks like, light brownish head, no stick head, but I've already poured it slightly. But yes, see, it does kind of smell thin on the aroma, but you are getting all the elements of a strong ale. It smells so good. It has kind of like a brown bready element to it. But you do get those almost like toffee elements that I was expecting from the Horbury beer. Cheers. Now, I've not had this for a while, it still tastes good to me. It's a little bit on a thin to medium, but the density in the brewing style, yeah, the textures that flow through this beer, still good to me. But you can see that it is kind of on the thin side for a strong ale, but it is only 5.3%. It has a cold tea element to it, like an Earl Grey. Almost like a black tea. Anyway. The mouthfeel is lovely. And it doesn't overly kill your palate. It's nice to cleanse the palate. But yes, good beer. I've already opened it. That's bad, 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 bad. So, Zapato. So, it's an export porter. Color helmets there is good. 7%. Now the artwork, yeah. Try to see where it is. It looks like lightning bolts and refineries. It looks like maybe some sort of space station. I'm not too sure. But they're based out of Leeds. But it says here that it's brewed. Oh yeah. So it's after brewed. Based out of Marsden, but I know he does a lot of Leeds events, but this was brewed at Runaway Brewery in Manchester. So it's nice to see Marsden and Manchester referenced into one beer. But yeah, the guy from Zapato met him at Brutinal Beer Festival around this time a few years back, when beer festivals were allowed. And yeah, I think he just basically bounces in between breweries and such brewed beers under the Zapato label. But yeah, it looks like Runaway. Runaway makes some good beers too. Not seen them for a while, but anyway, back on this beer. So she's Doom. Kind of get some like burnt caramels, but yeah, cheers. Oh, that's nice as well. Yes, so you kind of get some black pepper, there's some sort of body is medium. It does taste like cold coffee. It's weird. The final two that I was going to select for this Tryanuary thing, one tastes like cold coffee, one tastes like cold tea. But there's a nice under the lip sticky feel to it, which is nice. It's nice. I've got to change it around and get some positive about this Tryanuary thing. Try one new brewery and try two breweries I've not had for a while. But yes, at least two other four beers would be good. I'm going to relax with these four beers now. Check out Beer House out. That's it. Horbury beers might be better on cask. That's typically the ML. If it's not good on cowball, it's better on the other. But pub's not open, and beer festivals are not operating at the moment, so people can't relay real information back and forth. That's done when our breweries test their boundaries. They release their beers at a beer festival and then see how it blossoms. But yes, the Boom Export Porter, good. Yeah, well, I'm not a big fan of wraparound. It's not good for my pictures. The other side was good. That's low end quality, safe bet beer. The two other beers, they might get better, but they can't get any worse. Yeah, check out beer house out. It's the other side out of Harrogate. Zapato, all over the joint. Yorkshire, Lancashire. Ooh, Lowell's where next? You take care. Goodbye.